What's happening, hardscapers? We're back and we are finishing up these steps, except for the sand, poly sand. We need to wait for that, the steps to dry to be able to finish that, as well as the edge restraint. But we're gonna get the landings laid that are gonna match our patio and walkway. We're gonna get our trench done for our electrical, for the transformer for the lighting, as well as the pond pump. And we're gonna get holes dug with our new battery powered auger. So let's get into this. It's a messy job site right now, but basically what we've done here is we've laid our landings from each one. And the idea is we're gonna concrete edge across this and then do our poly sand when it's dry. As you can see, some of them are a bit wet. It was supposed to rain today, so we didn't prepare for any poly sand today anyways, but all the lighting is on. And we got our drain here, going down and across to a pop-up emitter. Had our trench going, but our geo ripper again, the screw fell out, and now I can't find the screw. That's two screws down, same hole, so it must be the hole that's stripped or something like that, but can't get the trench done, so we're gonna do our pulse holes. This is really hard clay. Like this, I'm holding it outright. It just doesn't fall apart. This is, it's the hardest clay you'll ever run into. Rocks like this, of this size, it's gonna struggle with quite a bit and kick back at you quite a bit. Like, look at this stuff. This is the stuff that nightmares are made of. End of day 14 here. We finished the landing of the steps minus the concrete edge restraint we're gonna do for the pavers as well as the polymeric sand. It was supposed to rain today again. It was supposed to rain all week. Today turned out to be sunny. Those pavers are drying off. We couldn't even got the poly sand done if we wanted to. Then I wanted to get the trench done for the electrical that they might be showing up tomorrow. They haven't gotten back to me on that, but for them to show up tomorrow, the trench, I only got about 10 feet and the screw fell out of the head of the Geo Ripper again. It's a brand new screw. I put Loctite on it and for whatever reason, it must be the head on it that the threads are starting. I have no idea, but that thing's giving me more troubles. I couldn't find that screw anymore. I got one screw left that came with the tool. So, you know, hopefully that goes in, that stays in, because I still got quite a bit of trenching to do. And I especially have to get there early tomorrow to get that trenching done. I used a brand new Ryobi one man battery powered earth auger. And that thing worked like a charm to get down to what I needed to for the posts that are gonna set the transformers, for the lights for the pond, the pump for the pond, electrical outlet, as well as the transformer for the lights. So there's two separate posts there. And also the clients having a hot tub going in eventually. So we're gonna rough that in for them as well, or the electrician is. But this machine, you know, for a battery powered piece of equipment, really worked well. I couldn't believe it. This area is known for extremely hard clay. And I was really worried about getting something because I can't get a machine back there. And I was really worried about what I was gonna do about, you know, I'm not gonna hand dig these dang holes. So I found this battery powered Ryobi earth auger, and you know, Ryobi is not known for making earth augers. So I put it to the test and it worked out much better than I thought it would. Power is not a problem with that piece of equipment. And I'm really happy about how that worked in that hard clay. And we're moving along on this job. Thanks for watching these videos, these vlogs. If you find them helpful, if you find them fascinating, if you find them interesting enough to watch them all the way through, I appreciate that. Feel free to like, subscribe, whatever you need to do to show your support. And I appreciate you. Thanks for watching.